Welcome to my channel. In this video, I will show you my first coloring in the newest book by Alena Lazareva, Christmas Surprise. A day ago, I posted a flip through of this beautiful book. I have artist edition book printed in Russia on very good, very thick paper at 200 GSM. Book is one-sided, so you don't have to limit yourself to any media. You can use whatever you want. And I decided to do this paper a thorough test. In this book we have plenty of nice winter Christmas pictures, and I do love pictures with interior designs, all those fireplaces, Christmas trees, also with children unpacking presents or decorating Christmas tree. But as my first project I selected this one. It's a toy shop. You know that I love vintage style pictures, especially like Victorian time pictures, and when I look at the toys which we have inside of the shop and also girls' dress, I think that it also has some vintage style, so probably that's why I selected it. It has a lot of details, all those toys, Christmas ornaments, many things which are standing on the shelves and inside the shelves. So I decided to make it a very quick speed coloring video. I included only parts which I was thinking that they will be able to give you opinion about paper quality, or maybe how I colored some interesting details like girl, dollhouse. And besides, I think that the dollhouse was one of the reasons why I decided to color it. When I was a little girl, I always dreamed to have similar doll's house. So my first test was with alcohol-based markers. I do promise myself to use my alcohol-based markers more frequently, so I decided to test them here. I knew that I have nice Copic marker, which can serve as a color for the walls, and that it can be used together with Faber-Castell Polycolor Caput Mortum. Marker is slightly lighter, and Caput Mortum, when I used it on top of the marker, helped me to create shadow, which I needed. So marker behaved really well, and with such thickness of paper it even almost didn't bleed through. But of course I protected the rest of the book with a clear file which I put beneath the paper. Also I decided that with markers I can do first layer of the wooden parts on the shelves, and then I will add wooden texture, all those lines, rings and also shadows using pencils. I thought that it will help me to color it quicker. I tested several pencils brands here, and I would say that even if all of them behave and blend here really well, my favorite on this paper are Prismacolors. They work like butter on silk on this paper. Definitely I will plan to use them on my next projects here. Also, on the lower part of the page, on the floor, I decided to do a watercolor test, and watercolors also behaved quite well, so they will be my second medium for the next pictures from this book. First, I was surprised when I put the first layer of paint, very light yellow ochre, to put the basic color for the floor, and paper didn't absorb pigment at all. I was a little bit afraid. Sometimes when paper is too smooth or too glossy, there is this effect when paper doesn't absorb pigment, and when it did absorb it finally and became dry, it created ugly stains. But here it wasn't such thing. I simply was allowed to work quite slowly here to add colors which I wanted to the basic color. So I added more intense yellow, then I added more brown color, darker color in the areas where I wanted to create shadows, and when everything dried, paints, they blended together really well, there were no stains. I was able to do multiple glazing layers, one on top of the other, The surface of the paper wasn't damaged, so it's absolutely perfect for watercolors. And for such slow watercolor colorists as I am, it's also very helpful. You don't have to rush, you don't have to work very quickly, you have time to think which colors you want to use, which colors you need to blend, and in the end you will have quite nice results. So I was very pleasantly surprised. When I colored the main part of the background, the wall, the floor and shelves, I realized that I have to be quite careful with the color selection for the rest of the objects here. With so many small elements, with so many details, this picture risked to be extremely motley. You know that all my pictures are very colorful and I tend to use many colors on each of the pages. But here I definitely didn't want to lose the girl or the doll's house. They are definitely the focal points here. And I decided that I will try to limit myself at least to several colors. So I tried to select several red objects, then yellow golden objects, and the rest of the animals I tried to color with gray and brown. Only the doll near the doll's house I did also quite bright because it's also in the focal point of this composition. I'm glad that I selected this page and that I colored it. As my next project, I plan to color one of the pictures with fireplaces and Christmas tree. And then in January, I will start to color all those Russian style pictures inspired by Palech-Lac illustrations, and there I intend to use more opaque paints like acrylic or gouache, especially for the background, to get the same bright colors which are quite traditional for the Russian miniatures. Thank you for watching and don't miss my flip through of this book because it's definitely one of the best Christmas books I own and I have a lot of them.